Thank you very much, Dr. Vinicius. The objective of this session, which we consciously planned in the form of a panel discussion, is to make this session as interactive as possible, because you all know what the process is actually when any new idea, new thought, or anything, something which is not in existence or unexplored. If it has to come, at some point of time, it needs to discuss what actually is in existence. And then, a study of that existence, it gives a glimpse that, yes, of course, we do have something, but there are certain things, certain dimensions which are missing. And the quest for identify that missing component, in fact, raises the need of exploring further and identify something new. And that's where academia comes into. So academia can research any idea which conceives generally. It is not necessary and sufficient condition, but definitely it's somewhere. Generally, it starts from academic community, where idea conceives, some initial preliminary study is done by all of you who are sitting here. And then, once that idea conceives, you do something, it comes to the knowledge of other domains. And that's where thinking, can that idea be translated or transformed into a product, facility, or services? That's where industry comes in. So role of academia and research is very important as far as creation of knowledge is concerned. But creation of knowledge is not of much use if it remains in the books or in the research papers. It has to be translated into a product or service, which we can use, we can feel, we can experience. So industry is there that evaluates, assesses, and try to find out, can that idea be translated into a usable product or service? That's where industry is. Now once industry come up with that product, that idea which conceives in academia, developed or translated into a form of product or services by industry, then it needs to be used, tested. That's where the users, the consumers, which may be an academic institution also, which may be a business also. And that's where the people, those who are actually using those services, those facilities, their inputs are very much required. Because it gives a feedback at how much, up to what extent we succeeded in our efforts. And then once it is used, it needs to be propagated among people. It needs to be publicized among people, and that's where we are media. So a conscious effort was made while forming this panel that let's try to create a panel where people from each vertical who are very important to this entire ecosystem, right from academic, the conceptualization, conceiving the idea, till getting it to the masses, because until now there are a number of products which are in existence. But if it be of the prestigious colleges in the country, Lady Sri Ram College,
thank you so much, ma'am. We welcome you here at IGS in this ICT summit.
Then the people, those who are behind translating those ideas into a product. AMD. और AMD को हम लोग शायद एक प्रोसेसर जो CPU या ग्राफिकल GPUs के रूप में जो टेक्निकली हम जानते हैं, लेकिन अगर आप देखेंगे बाहुबली मूवी, हम सब लोगों ने देखी, we have seen this बाहुबली मूवी. बाहुबली was creation of a product which is of AMD. That entire graphical design which you have seen in बाहुबली मूवी, whether it was part one or part two, AMD has played a very crucial role in terms of the tools which have been used for it. And we have a person from AMD, business head, AMD, Shri Manikandan Iyer ji with us. And sometimes the technology is discussed, is talked. What has happened in session one? Where people talked about technology. And there are people, those who are practicing technology, demonstrating technology. So he will be the person who will talk about more the practical orientation of how technology is actually implemented. And then, in any concern, probably the most important department as far as students are concerned, the human resource department. And this is one of the consumers of all these products and services which have been created by information and communication technology. The person who is actually using technology, not into development of technology, but using technology. And a third eye view, person who practices, who uses the technology, it's very important for you, human resource department, if you look as a student after completing your course, the input from a HR professional is very much required. We have Dr. Pannel Mishraji, who is Chief People Officer of MagicMix.com. You all know that company. Again, you work with me. And then the person, in fact, when I tried to introduce him, just one small request to you. If anybody is not interested, this is a general discussion, they will leave this hall immediately. They will leave this hall immediately, if not interested. When TV channels were not there, we used to see Doordarshan, whether it was Ramayana, whether it was Mahabharata, whether it was quiz contest, and the first ever quiz on TV was introduced by Doordarshan. And the person who conceived that idea of conducting quiz on television, and we conducted for almost 4 years, India Quiz, Mr. Priyan Dwivedi. He is accepted our request and ensured that in spite of all his commitment, you know how busy media people are. It's very difficult to catch them. But then on our first request, he has accepted our request and he is here. Thank you so much and welcome here, Priyan Dwivedi. So now, I will be starting because the sequence has been from academia towards taking it to the masses. And if you see this panel, the sitting arrangement has been made in that way. The anchor who anchors this entire discussion passes to academia and it goes to the masses from media. And in between, idea conceives, created and translated into product, practiced by professionals, and taken to the masses by media but for awareness. So I will be starting with Dr. Sushila Madandi, one of the known names, and I met first time on the forum of Computer Society of India, where she expressed her concern by for taking this IT and IT education to those who are deprived of, those who are underprivileged. And I'm sure the person who has that kind of understanding, that kind of thought process, he speaks from the heart, but it's what he or she feels. So with our original thoughts, I will be inviting Dr. Sushila Madandi. Just what we will be doing, the format what we have taken, we will just have 2 minute introduction from each of us. Introduction about the perspective on which they are going to speak. And then we will have discussion on those topics. And then.
Good morning to you all, or good noon. Good morning.
Good morning.
I hope your focus and 100% attention is going to be there, right? Great. Should I stand? आपका आपको आज का थीम पता है सेशन का क्या है? क्या है? आईसीटी आगे? नेशन बिल्डिंग भी कुछ है बिल्डिंग नेशन वेरी गुड तो आपके हिसाब से नेशन बिल्डिंग के क्या पैरामीटर्स हैं आप नेशन कैसे बिल्ड होता है कैन एनीबॉडी टेल आप बता सकते हो कि नेशन बिल्डिंग के लिए क्या जरूरी है हाँ आपकी सुई अटक गई लगता है फोकस करना अटेंशन पे करना ये नेशन बिल्डिंग का है डेफिनेटली इन डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली इट पेज और टेक्नोलॉजी क्योंकि आप उसी उस फोरम में बैठे हैं डेफिनेटली यस वो तो आपका है ही आज का गेम और कुछ आप कैसे कहते हैं कंट्री डेवलप्ड है नेशन बिल्डिंग के क्या पैरामीटर्स हो सकते हैं Yes. हम बोलते हैं जिस कंट्री की जीडीपी हाई है पर कैपिटा पर इनकम ग्रोथ इज हायर जिसकी इकोनॉमी ज्यादा अच्छी है अगर आप शेयर्स के मार्केट को कुछ समझते हैं अगर उसमें सेंसेक्स बढ़ता है इंडेक्स बढ़ता है तो हम बोलते हैं कि कंट्री का यू नो इट्स एडवांस और वी कैन से इट इज अ डेवलपिंग कंट्री और डेवलप्ड कंट्री आप डेवलप्ड कंट्रीज किनको मानते हैं Very good. UK को, नहीं करते होंगे You do not know how to exploit the possibilities of a mobile phone. You need to learn that too. And then we decided that let's have the intervention of notebooks. We gave a pilot program to 30 villages, a notebook, all the teachers, and showing we had some kind of education programs in those notebooks, and which they started showing to the young children. आपको पता है गवर्नमेंट के कितने इनिशिएटिव्स हैं? आपको एनपीटीएल के बारे में मालूम होगा? मालूम है? That you can have your IT lectures prepared by your IIT professors and renowned professors of IIIT and Harvard and many other from industry. They have come up with a forum of specialized expert lectures which you can anybody can use. आप देख सकते हो उनको. And you can आप जो practices हैं कि आप उन lectures को पहले सुनो और आपकी class में वो lecture पढ़ाया नहीं जाएगा. You are supposed to discuss those problems. So I conceived the same idea to them, and then thrice it was done the survey by Aspiring Mind, Tara Dhan and Pratham. And their observation was that those students of villages are much better equipped with Hindi, English, science and mathematics, better than public and private schools, government and private schools in Delhi and otherwise in various metro cities. And it was a remarkable and big, I mean the kind of question asked and how many answers, I mean that survey is full proof, and that was been projected in CSR, and we got the funds again of 2 crores for further distribution of those notebooks. Now the pilot program is going to be in 150 villages. That's how we are empowering education, and then whatever they are doing in organic farming, in terms of forming the soap pit. हमारे यहाँ पे बारिश होती है, पानी बहता है, तो वो ज़मीन में नहीं जाता. लेकिन उनको हम बताते हैं कि आप ये वाला पानी ज़मीन में कैसे जाए. So they have whatever procedure they adopt, and what we have told them, they do it on the basis of now whatever being told to them is being now. With IIT Mumbai, we have developed an app to create further apps, which further teaches to those people, those who want to be expert in plumbing, cutting, tailoring, forming the soap pit, or forming the organic farming. That's how we are trying to build up with the students' nation. And I would like all of you to be a part of it. And have a visit and see what you can do. Right? कहते हैं ना जीना सार्थक तभी होता है जब हम कुछ करते हैं और हम satisfaction तभी आती है और उससे भी ऊपर है कि आप जब भी कुछ करते हैं ऐसा तो आपको अनचाहा भी जो आप सोचते हो वही आपको मिल जाता है. So I end my discussion here and further you can open to any kind of question. Thank you.
The government policies and things which are happening in technology domain, they are really opening up, are showing the destination which should be the destination what we are aspiring for. So there are challenges, and definitely the challenges you have to take care of after few years down the line when you will be in a responsible position. Because the challenge what we are seeing, that technology is opening the way, but still if you see the most important vehicle for which is driving this entire process is your smartphone. And the biggest challenge is digital divide. The digital divide, when we define, we say that once upon a time, जब पहले कभी किसी को हम differentiate करते थे तो हम कहते थे ये करोड़पति है. और differentiate करने का दोनों पे एक different dimension हुआ करता था. लेकिन आज जो dimension है कि आपके पास IT enabled services, IT का access है या नहीं. अगर आपके पास है तो आप डिजिटली प्रिविलेज्ड हैं, अगर आपके पास नहीं है तो आप अंडर प्रिविलेज्ड हैं. ये जो गैप है किसी के पास डिजिटल सर्विसेज का होना और नहीं होना, ये जो गैप है इसी को हम डिजिटल गैप कहते हैं, और यही डिवाइड करता है सोसाइटी को, इसको हम डिजिटल डिवाइड कहते हैं. नाउ अगर आप देखें इसको तो हमारे जो अर्बन पार्ट है, अर्बन पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री, इसमें जो पेनिट्रेशन है वो 51% का है.
That's where the limitations are, and those limitations are opportunities for you to develop applications and solutions there. In urban areas now, if you see growth, which was recently published, that in urban areas, the technology is now, has reached at a level where now its growth is reduced. In that urban part, where the growth is about 9%. But in rural, we have started to use it. And last 2 years, the rural part of the growth in the adoption is 26%. And it is expected to continue. So definitely, this we have to take all these things to the masses, to those who are not privileged. We need to do something so that this also reaches them, they understand it. Or aap sabhi logo ko ye student as aur jo log isme IT ke IT students ke liye sabse badi opportunity hai ki India software ke mamle mein mana jata hai ki Bharat ki jo puri GDP hai usme ek bahut major jo chunk hai wo IT ka hai lekin durbhagya ye hai ki IT mein hum software mein to puri duniya mein hum jaane jaate hain hardware mein hum kahin hai though there are companies which are starting manufacturing mobile phones in India aur 6 mobile manufacturers mein parson Bharat net ka jo bhi jikr kar rahe hain सुबह में जिक्र हुआ भारत में जो भारत गवर्नमेंट का एक इनिशिएटिव है कि 6 मोबाइल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनियों ने ये एग्रीमेंट साइन किया है कि जैसे आप जो मोबाइल फोन खरीदते हैं तो फ्री इंस्टॉल्ड ऐप्स आते हैं तो भारत नेट विल बी वन ऐप विच विल बी इंस्टॉल्ड फ्री विल बी प्री इंस्टॉल्ड इन मोबाइल शायद इस तरीके के जो डिवाइस होंगे एप्लीकेशन को चीजों को आगे ले जाएंगे तो ना अगर आगे ले जाने की बात तो लोगों तक पहुंचाने की बात हो तो मीडिया का सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट होता है तो मैं वहां से सीधे उनके पास आऊंगा जो इस चीज को मासेस तक ले जाए।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी और गुड मॉर्निंग मैं इसलिए कह रहा हूँ क्योंकि डॉक्टर मदान ने कहा है और चूंकि वो टीचर हैं तो उनकी बात सही हमेशा होती है टीचर्स इसीलिए मैं भी आपको गुड मॉर्निंग कह रहा हूँ और वैसे भी आप थोड़े सोए सोए से लग रहे हैं तो जब जाके तभी सवेरा न्यू इंडिया की जब हम बात करते हैं मीडिया के रोल की हम बात करते हैं तो बहुत सारे एलिमेंट्स इसमें हैं और जिस तरीके से टेक्नोलॉजी पिछले कुछ टाइम में चेंज हुई है कन्वर्ट हुई है इवॉल्व हुई है डेवलप हुई है हमने देखा है कि पूरी जो हमारी फिल्मिंग है उसमें चेंजेस आए हैं हमारी जो प्रोसेसेस हैं उनमें चेंज आए हैं हमारी जो रीच है उसमें चेंज आए हैं जो डिजिटल हुआ है मीडिया उससे हमारी क्वालिटी बढ़ी है उससे हमारी एक्सेसिबिलिटी बढ़ी है और लोग हम लोगों तक ही नहीं लोग भी हम तक पहुंच पा रहे हैं एक ये एक बहुत बड़ा चेंज आया है पहले क्या होता था कि अगर हम देखें तो न्यूज़पेपर होता था तो प्रिंट होता था नेक्स्ट डे आप तक न्यूज पहुंचती थी या जब टेलीविजन स्टार्ट हुआ तो टेलीविजन में भी ये रहा कि वन वे कम्युनिकेशन है हम जो वो हम तक पहुंचा रहे हैं आप जो तो देख रहे हैं यहाँ भी टेक्नोलॉजी है तो वो टू वे कम्युनिकेशन कभी नहीं हो पाया था लेकिन जब से सोशल मीडिया आई सोशल मीडिया इज बिकॉज ऑफ आपकी टेक्नोलॉजी और सोशल मीडिया ने हर आदमी को आज की डेट में रिपोर्टर बन गया हर आदमी के हाथ में मोबाइल फोन है जो वीडियोस रिकॉर्ड कर सकता है जो पिक्चर्स कैप्चर कर सकता है जिस भी जगह पे आप हैं जो भी सिचुएशन आपकी है उसको आप कैप्चर करते हैं और आप देखते हैं कि अभी रिसेंटली एनडीटीवी ने स्टार्ट किया है मोजो करके मोबाइलिज्म कर तो हम एक नए एरा में बढ़ रहे हैं एक नया फेज हम लोग फेस करने जा रहे हैं डेफिनेटली हमारी रीच अप्रोच सब चीजें बढ़ी हैं आप देखते हो कंप्यूटर सीजी में कंप्यूटर ग्राफिक्स में एएमडी से हमारे भाई साहब यहाँ बैठे हैं ही अंडरस्टैंड्स दीस थिंग्स बेटर कितना ज्यादा चेंज आया बाहुबली की जैसे बात हो रही थी तो कितना जबरदस्त हम लोग चीजें देख पा रहे हैं तो अब बाहर अवतार बनी थी थोड़े दिन में आप इंडिया में भी देख पाएंगे बिकॉज ऑफ दी एएमडी है ना लेकिन एक छोटा सा एलिमेंट यहाँ पे ये है कि न्यू इंडिया की जब हम बात करते हैं टेक्नोलॉजी की बात करते हैं तो हर चीज के दो पहलू होते हैं मेरी बड़ी गंदी आदत है कि मैं हमेशा दूसरी दिशा से शुरू करता हूं तो जो नेगेटिव पॉइंट है ना उसको आप इग्नोर नहीं कर सकते। टेक्नोलॉजी का मिसयूज भी उतना ही है जितना यूज हो सकता है। अच्छा, मिसयूज का ये मतलब नहीं है कि कोई मिस उसको यूज कर रही तो उसको मिसयूज बोलते हैं, है ना। तो ये बहुत रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी भी हम लोग की बनती है यहाँ पे कि कोई भी ये हमारे हाथ में, इट इज अ वेपन सॉर्ट ऑफ थिंग। आपके हाथ में अगर आपका फोन जो है, अगर आपकी बैंक से लिंक करके आपको ईज प्रोवाइड कर रहा है, तो उसका अदर साइड ऑफ द स्टोरी भी हो सकता है, जो होता है, आई दिन हैकिंग के केसेस सामने आते हैं या दूसरे तरीके से भी टेक्नोलॉजी का मिसयूज होता है। तो इन सब चीजों पे भी हमें, जब चूंकि हम न्यू इंडिया की बात कर रहे हैं, तो हमें उस कॉन्टेक्स्ट में वी हैव टू रिफर दिस आल्सो कि भाई चीजें बढ़ें, ये जरूरी है, लेकिन वो इस तरीके से आगे बढ़े ताकि वो हार्मफुल भी ना हो। तो इस बारे में भी हम लोग शायद बात कर सकते हैं, और मैं ओपन रहूंगा आपके किसी भी सवाल के जवाब देने के लिए, और दैट्स ऑल आई हैव टू से अबाउट नाउ। थैंक यू,
थैंक यू प्रोफेसर। दैट्स व्हाट अ जर्नलिस्ट डू। जनरली व्हेन पैनल्स आर कंडक्टेड, द पैनल मेंबर स्पीक्स लेस, द पर्सन हु मॉडरेट्स ही स्पीक्स लेस। वी आर लाइक अ सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर। Once upon a time, when we used to ask an IT student, what is your objective, he used to say, he used to answer, software engineer. Now, software engineer, we can tell you. Now people say, I want to be a tester. I want to be a database person. I want to be in AI-based or soft computing. Because it is going to impact each and every one who is sitting here. So definitely, when we use technology, we need to be responsible. And we need to take care of whether we are using this technology responsibly. Social media में हमें से सारे लोग होंगे, अगर कुछ कितने लोग नहीं हैं, तो कोई जो हाथ उठाएगा 99% उम्मीद है कि गलत होगा।
नहीं, सब उसका profile आईडी दूसरा होगा।
ये means ये most of us are in social media. लेकिन आप देखते हैं कि social media में हमें कभी, अगर हम आपसे एक दूसरे से मिलते हैं, आप किसी आपके कोई classmate है कोई, आप उससे मिलते हैं, बात करते हैं, over the period आप कहते हैं कि हमारा दोस्त है। जिस दिन पहले दिन आप अपने कॉलेज में आए, उस दिन आप नहीं कहते कॉलेज वाला आपका दोस्त, बिकॉज यू डोंट नो। तो दोस्ती का एक पैरामीटर होता है कि कंसिस्टेंटली आप डिफरेंट ओकेजन पे आप उसको ऑब्जर्व करते हैं, एसेस करते हैं, एंड ओवर द पीरियड एक ट्रस्ट डेवलप होता है, एंड दैट ट्रस्ट कन्वर्टेड इनटू दोस्ती। बट फेसबुक पे आप हैं, एक फ्रेंड रिक्वेस्ट आती है जिसको आपने कभी देखा ना, आपने कभी बात की, एंड यू टेंड टू एक्सेप्ट दैट फ्रेंड रिक्वेस्ट विदाउट नोइंग हु इज द पर्सन सिटिंग अदर। And there are lots of cases which are now coming in court. ये छोटा सा केस था, मैं just एक मिनट लेके चलूँ। सब कुछ होता है, 15 दिन के बाद अचानक उस बच्चे ने जो दूसरे साइड पर जो भी था उसने चैटिंग बंद कर दी। अब आप किसी से लगातार चैटिंग कर रहे हैं 15 दिनों, अचानक बंद करके रिस्पॉन्ड करना, तुम्हें तुम्हें अभी सोचता है क्या बात होगी। अब वो जो बच्ची थी उसको लगा कि कहीं ऐसा कोई किसी परेशानी में हो कुछ, उसने सी ड्रॉप पे मैसेज कि भाई बहुत दिन से कोई बात नहीं हो पा रही, कोई दिक्कत, कोई परेशानी। सडनली अपीयर्स कि माय मॉम इज इन वेरी क्रिटिकल कंडीशन, आई नीड 10 लाख रुपीस, आई हैव समहाउ मैनेज्ड 4-5 लाख एंड रेस्ट आई एम अरेंजिंग, एंड इफ आई डू नॉट अरेंज इन नेक्स्ट फ्यू डेज माय मदर इज लाइकली टू बी शी देयर। अब अगर कोई आप किसी को दोस्त कहें और वो कहे आपसे ऐसी बात, उसकी मदर की हालत क्रिटिकल है, और सोशल मीडिया पर कोई मुलाकात कभी नहीं हुई, एंड उस बच्ची ने अगर और आपके पास पैसा नहीं तो सिंपैथी जताएं, इतना तो करें, और अगर कैपेबल है तो उसको मदद करना चाहिए, एंड उसको लगा कि इसकी मदर की हालत अगर इतनी खराब है, तो फिर दिन मतलब दो दिन की चैटिंग के बाद व्हाट शी डिड, अपने पेरेंट्स की मदर अपने घर में लॉकर था, उसमें वो अपना कुछ सामान वगैरह रखा था, उन्होंने शी टुक आउट ज्वेलरी एंड कैश जो भी कर लिया था, उसने कहा कि एक हफ्ते में मैं वापस कर दूंगा बिकॉज सम मनी हैज टू कम, ले जाके दे दिया उस बच्ची ने, मिले रेस्टोरेंट में दे दिया, एंड उसके बाद उसने अपनी प्रोफाइल डिलीट कर दी जो सामने वाला बच्चा। अब घर में सामान जो रखा हुआ, इट्स अ रियल केस, इट इज इट हैज बीन टेकन केयर बाय एसआईटी मुंबई, और अभी इस केस को उन्होंने क्लोज भी कर दिया। नाउ उसमें क्या हुआ, जब वो पता, जब वो मम्मी ने दो तीन बार चार दिन के बाद देखा होगा, उन्होंने कुछ नहीं किया, तो बच्ची ने रोते रोते सारी बात बताई। अब पेरेंट्स पुलिस में गए, अब जब पुलिस में गए देन फर्दर जो इंक्वायरी होती है, फाइनली पुलिस को ट्रेस, आप किसी से चैट करते हैं, किसी को मैसेज देते हैं, तो आपका सिस्टम
ड्रेस आउट हो सकता है कि कौन सी मशीन है, ठीक। तो अब ये फेसबुक फ्रेंडली थे, तो वी नीड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल व्हाइल यूजिंग सोशल मीडिया एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। अगर हम सही से उसको यूज करें तो आप जानते हैं कि इट कैन डू वंडर्स। देयर लॉट्स ऑफ डिस्कशन कैन बी ऑन दिस, बट वी विल हैव टू स्टॉप हियर एंड इनवाइट मणिकंदन जी टू प्रेजेंट हिज पर्सपेक्टिव।
So, today I'll be covering a broad spectrum of what ICT is. If I have to start with an example, have you heard about something called as cloud technology?
Yes.
So, what is cloud? Can you tell me? It can be very simple. Well, what is cloud? What do you call cloud technology? Yes. Anybody, please be free. It's like a very classroom kind of discussion. Consider me as your friend and please be open. I am open to discussion. We all are bound to make mistakes. Don't worry about it. Please, when do you think cloud started becoming popular in India? Let's say somewhere around 2006-07, when it became a fad, everybody started doing a cloud-based course or something, right? Have you guys noticed you have been using cloud and other related technologies indirectly without even noticing it? Can you guys let me know what is it? जो आप लोग mail use करते हो, Yahoo mail, अरे Gmail, they are all based out of cloud technology, right? Where does your information get stored? It is stored, let's say, with the company that hosts all this particular application. So cloud आप लोग use कर रहे थे, but you didn't know कि yes it is directly linked to the particular technology. The same is with ICT. So we will have a prolonged discussion, जहाँ पर I will say कि how all these things have started, what are the technology, let's say we call it a deviation point, जहाँ से ना it would have grown up exponentially. So we will talk about that. We will also cover something called as SWOT analysis. You know, SWOT analysis, bale, you know, you would have seen when you have done a management course or something, but you know, Indians, you have to give to them, they are very good in SWOT analysis. Students, tell you, they have 100 rupees in their pocket. Okay? First thing, what they will do is calculate. Yeah, isse na, I have to cross, let's say, a week's time. Possibilities, opportunities, okay? What are my strengths? अगर मान लो मैं 100 रुपए एक हफ्ता चला लेता हूँ, उसके बाद I'll get money from my mom or my dad, or I can still borrow it from my friend, okay? Friend, यार party आ रहा है, I have to recharge my mobile phone, all these things are coming up, how do I survive? So, trust me, every opportunity we come across it on a day-to-day basis, again, unknowingly we do the SWOT analysis. We don't name it as SWOT analysis, but we do it. So we will have a detailed discussion on ICT, how a SWOT analysis can be done. Or beech-beech mein, I'll give you some good fun facts so that you also don't sleep, I also don't sleep. I have seen few faces which are, you know, getting a bit dull from the morning session. I'll give you lots of fun facts, don't worry about that. No, one good thing is, you know, even though we have all got into modern technologies, we always have this traditional approach of writing in papers. We all have that. However, let's say we progress, we always have this habit of noting it down in papers. Q, reuse the paper, but he can rewrite his own comments. Mano, he notes down, okay, ki I have made a presentation for 15 minutes. The next time he goes, either he can correct it or either he can improve upon it. And they underline each and every things that you say. Orange, may, if they underline it, it's like it has a timeline of a week. I've checked with them. I was very curious when they are underlining each and every statement I said. I was scared. No, I took them out for a dinner and they're happy again. They do dinners very early. Let's say 7, 8 o'clock. So I said, I had this thing. Can I know why you guys use different kind or colors of pen? They said to me, you know, we do that so that we do not forget it in our own timeline. So they underlined it, and this is what it is meant for them to follow up with us, so that there is a tracker sitting across. That's how they have evolved. Even though still we have calendars, we have outlooks, they follow this tradition. So when we speak, I'll keep giving you some interesting facts. And you know, there is a responsibility for each and every speaker sitting over here. If you ask me, why? Because we are addressing the face of the nation. Each and everything we say gets carried across. So let's have a very interactive session. You know, please do come up with points where I can share my experience. I can learn an experience from you guys and maybe take it across. I have lots of points to discuss with you, do not worry. I'll make it much more interesting if it, you know, takes that pace. And look forward for your input. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.
He just very just upon very practical dimensions which needs to be taken care of by each of us. And in last, towards the end of his talk, he emphasized basically on three terms. Learn, that in any case, as a student, each of us in some or other way is a student. So as a student, we have learned. We have to learn something which we can use in the future. But technology and the concepts are changing in so faster pace that we can't remain same what we are today. Tomorrow technology will change, concept will change, new things will come. And if we do not learn those newer things, probably we will become irrelevant. But learning something and then learning something else, it is always better to write on a blank slate. So there is a phrase when we say, learn something today, use it, and tomorrow be ready to unlearn. Because until unless you unlearn, unlearn doesn't mean that what you learn today, you have just wiped out. Keep the substance with you, rest of the things needs to be updated with the current. So unlearn, and then you should have that space to relearn the things which will keep you relevant in every context. So thank you so much, teacher. When a teacher becomes a professional, business professional, when he speaks, only he speaks. I request Dr. Anil Kishwari.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey, Dr. Vidushi, Dr. Sushila, Dr. Mani, Dr. Dube. I'm calling everyone doctor because you know that's how he started. So it hardly matters whether you are a doctor, a doctorate or not. But the point is, it's always a great feeling to interact with budding managers, yeah, management students, MCAs, MBAs, BCAs. That's not very important, but the interesting thing is, the topic we have chosen is, what is that ICT, right? Information and communication technologies, the role of ICT in nation building. I don't know, how many of you are aware of a gentleman, one philosopher, one economist by the name Adam Smith, Scottish economist? Read it, right? Great. What he said is, all progressive nations, they focus on three aspects. When they talk about nation building, three are only the variables. Number one, what is the knowledge, what is the skill base, and what is the attitude, the overall resources, in this case, the people of a country they have. So the sum of knowledge, the skill, and the attitude put together forms the organization's, nation's overall knowledge base. Yeah? Now, knowledge. I'll give you an example. When we go to HR for an interview, we take, sir, I have done my master's in computer application. So this certificate gives me a guarantee that I am aware of the basic philosophies that is there in computer application. That to me, in a very simplistic language, is knowledge. Yeah? Skills. Fine, I have knowledge, but how well I can apply whatever I have learned? This is what we call skills. In HR we say, okay, this is your qualification, this is your years of experience. Is that fine? Third category, the most important is, I'm knowledgeable, I have the right kind of skill required to do a specific task, but I don't feel like doing. Yeah? That would not come in handy. Yeah? Attitude is the most important thing. So, wonderfully put together by Adam Smith, he said, nation building should focus on those three things. Rest all resources, technology, everything will come and go. They would evolve. Similarly, in our case also, we need to go through those phases. Most important one is the attitude part. Second one. Can you guess what is our total population right now? India's population. 131. Definitely more than 130 crore. Yeah? 1.3 billion. Out of that, second question is, can you guess how many of us in India, the age below 30, 35, what is our total population below the age of 35? What percentage? Any guesses?
70.
Close to 70% right now. You might have heard about baby boomers, Gen X, Gen Y, otherwise called as millennials. Right? Now we are target, we have target audience here. 99% or 97% of them would be Gen Yers. Yeah? What excites them is the story of Bahubali. Bahubali, the moment you talk about those things, okay, so we can connect. Now, where I'm coming from is, with all due respect to everyone here, when we talk about the learning methodology, we normally in HR use something called VAK scale. V stands for visual, A for auditory, K for kinesthetics. Okay? What excites people, the learning method, because you know we are in an academic institution, very important to understand what is my best or dominating style of learning. In what scenario, in what situation, I can actually think of learning it the maximum. Yeah? If it's one-sided conversation, then probably it's not going to help us out. So first and foremost, proper statement is probably our education system, our methodology of educating someone. Okay? But keeping that aside, second question. We might have heard of something called Fourth Industrial Revolution. World Economic Forum founder, chairman, he coins these words, I'm forgetting his name. First one was about agriculture, steam engine. Next one, second revolution was about electric bulb, plenty of other things, you know, got radio, those kind of a thing. Third thing, those forms, need to talk about your family, and then followed with PowerPoint presentations. Does that excite this Gen Yers? No, because they want to learn anything which they can touch and feel, and that gives them opportunity to engage, they learn the most. And hence, organizations have gone through their change processes. And it cuts across entire employee life cycle, be it an induction or be it your training and development or employee engagement for that matter. Number one, employee engagement. Let me step back. Induction. In induction, today what we do? We give iPad on the day of joining. Yeah? And you need to punch in all your data and everything. Then the induction, the learning would happen through iPad gamification modules. It happens in my company right now. In my previous company and the previous one. Now, what happens here? And it's not an alien word. Everyone, most of the IT services, most of the developed or learning organizations follow this method. Yeah? Why? Because the intent is people need to understand how well, how engaging I can make the overall experience. Of course, there are forms. We need to fill it up. In addition to that, what we do is, let's say, you know, some 30 member team, they join. 30 iPads will be given, and they would have a competition called Rookie versus Leadership Members. That will navigate them. These are gamification modules. All through games, people would try and learn. Number one. Number two, When I started my career, we used to do employee morale survey. How we will do? We will formulate some 40 questions in different themes. I have a manager who supports, the values, the fun at work, other stuff. Everybody needs to put a tick mark. Right now what we do? Talking about artificial intelligence, we have chatbots. If HR sends a mailer, people would say, no, HR is tracking who has said what. People would not come up. They would not share. They might not share what really is the trigger, what is bothering them. So the chatbot, what happens? The CEO would send an invite. The robot, the chatbots, they would frame 3 or 4 questions, and the benefit is it uses artificial intelligence. It will tell, hey, you know, out of this 300 people, these 10 people are not comfortable based on the response they give. It doesn't take much of time. It's not a once a year ritual, but then the systems have evolved over a period of time. If you don't do that, ICT, information and communication technology, has transformed all our lives. How do we manage an organization which has people from all those different strata? Now we have started talking about Gen Z, the people who have not even joined corporate world. They would also go through plenty of other technological transformation. How do we capture their attention? How do we make sure their knowledge base is enhanced? They learn the necessary skills and they have the right attitude. Okay? Now, when we talk about nation building, no rocket science. I believe in very simple fundamentals. I should not be looking at somebody else to come and help us out in our nation building. If I am a teacher, I am doing my job effectively to the best of my ability, I am contributing. If I am a doctor or if I am a practitioner, I should refrain from giving gifts. Plenty of other stuff. In Japan, what do they do? The productivity level goes higher. That's their way of raising a profit. They would manufacture more goods. Unfortunately, of course, we have this generation dividend which is shrinking when you talk about Japan. But then, if we have the strength of Gen Yers and Gen Z likely to join our industry, what is that each one of us going to be doing? And definitely HR plays a major role in that, in organization, in corporate world. But then the way we teach our kids as parents, our methodologies, the pedagogy has to go through plenty of changes. Considering what is changing, so big question we need to ask is, as professionals, are we ready? Do we understand the pulse? Are we ready? And if we know what excites them, are we catering to their needs? This is where each of us in our respective professions need to identify and address ASAP. Otherwise, probably we will be thrown out or we will miss the bus. That's all.
Thank you, sir. Now, all the speakers have given what they could have is they spoken for hours because they have their own expertise, their own domain they are dominating. Dr. Mishra is starting by calling everyone doctor, and everyone is doctor because doctor means an expert in his or her own domain. Of course, as an academician, PhD, when we do PhD, we are called a doctor, and a doctor is a formal recognition of the efforts that person does. But these are doctors who have not gone through that process, but through their experience and what they have contributed to the industry indirectly in the development, in the building of the nation, so they deserve to be called as doctors in their own stream.
Dr. Mishra,
in fact, he talked about the knowledge. Most of you are from IT background, if I'm not wrong. There are a group of people, those who go one step ahead, to convert that information into knowledge. And they become more successful. And there is a smaller group of people, those who still work on knowledge to create wisdom. So the process of transforming data to the wisdom
In fact, where we stop ourselves defines where we will reach. And the area where Dr. Mishra has pointed out artificial intelligence, and more broadly in IT we call it soft computing, which includes artificial intelligence, neural network, every whatever you can think of, it becomes in that. Now this is the time when the soft computing is dominating and almost has entered into every vertical. Once upon a time, as a student you might have studied MIS. It went through by covering the journey of executive systems, and now these systems have changed in such a way that we are talking about a technology called IoT, which is a real implementation of machine learning. Means if you see these three things are there. पहले पुराने कंप्यूटर्स के जमाने में देखें तो कंप्यूटर होता था उसमें इनपुट हम देते हम मतलब इंडिविजुअल हमारे जैसे लोग सिस्टम प्रोसेस करता था और जो रिजल्ट होता था वो हमें मिलता था प्रोग्राम लिखते हैं सी का प्रोग्राम लिखे प्रोग्राम आप लिखते हैं इनपुट आपने दो नंबर दिए प्रोग्राम में रन कराया रिजल्ट आपको मिल गया देन देयर वाज अ टाइम व्हेन दिस इनपुट वाज गिवन बाय सम मशीन प्रोसेसिंग यूज्ड टू टेक प्लेस एंड वो रिजल्ट हमारे लिए Now we are in an era where input is given by machine, being processed by machine, and that result is meant for machine. IoT में क्या होता है? आप ये कहते हैं ना कि आपका मोबाइल फोन है, आपको पता है कि आपके फ्रिज में पानी ठंडा होने में 10 मिनट लगता है, और सवेरे आप घर से now the next step what people are talking about from Internet of Things to Internet of Everything. कि why to restrict this entire process to machine? Let's improve people also. You have that experience. Thank you so much, Dr. Mishra, Dubeji, and I hand over this dais to Dr. Mishra. Thank you.
I would like to correct her. My domain is definitely Dr. Sunil Kumar said that my domain is. We are talking about our domain, but my domain is. Technically, it's cyber security. And this is my passion to do something extra. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'll take a 2 more minutes. मैं एक चीज तो ये कहना चाहूँगा कि आप मुझे कम्युनिकेट करके बताओ कि आप लोग यू आर रियली अवेक टेक्नोलॉजी जैसे चेंज हो रही है ना तो गीता में भी भगवान श्री कृष्ण ने कहा था ना सर्वधर्मान परित्यज्य मामेकं शरणं व्रज अहं त्वां सर्व पापेभ्यो मोक्षयिष्यामि महाशुचः वैसे ही टेक्नोलॉजी जो है ना वो आपकी लाइफ में आके सब कुछ छोड़ छाड़ देंगे आप टेक्नोलॉजी की शरण में चले जाएंगे तो भी लाइफ जो है वो आपकी ग्रेट हो जाएगी दिस इज फॉर श्योर बट एक एलिमेंट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है जैसे मैंने आपको बताया ना बड़ा नेगेटिव आदमी हूँ ब्लड ग्रुप पॉजिटिव है बट आई एम अ नेगेटिव पर्सन क्या है मैं एक आपको जोक सुनाता हूँ आपको थोड़े दिन पहले आपने कभी शायद सुना भी हो चाइनीज जोक है कि संडे के दिन आफ्टर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम पूरी फैमिली जो है वो इकट्ठी हुई तो सडनली जो लड़का था बच्चा था उसने देखा कि घर में एक आदमी है उसने अपनी माँ को बोला हु इज ही लुक्स गुड हु इज ही Is he your new friend? उसकी माँ ने उसको डांटा उसने बोला he's your father. So we are heading towards that era also. It is a joke, but it is an alarm also. हम इतना ज्यादा अपने फोन में अपने कंप्यूटर में इन्वॉल्व हैं वी आर मोर मैकेनिकल वी आर लेस सेल्फ सोल्ड तो हमें बैलेंस बना के भी रखना होगा इस चीज की भी हमारी ही रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी होनी चाहिए वो हम अब देखो वैसे
Why did it become so special? Have you heard about cameras
with 360 degree view?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, how is it different from the normal camera? Please, look, express your views. But if your normal camera, let's say you capture from your mobile phone, what do you get? Ah, okay, selfie, okay. Anything else? Let's say you record a video, what do you get? What do you see? Do you see a two-dimensional image? Right? Matlab, for example, you are having a view on this particular row, sirf yahi row dikhega. If it is a 360 degree camera, it is nothing special. We actually designed the camera for this team. It was nothing but a 16 camera bundled into a glue. It was nothing different. It was a simple technology wherein 16 cameras were bundled into a glue. It was kept at particular height. It captured the shots or the scenes wherein the actors were acting. Usse kya hua? Have you heard about a technology called as 3D printing?
Yes.
Kya karta? For example, if I want a water bottle, I don't need to have an exact plastic bottle to it. I can do a 3D printed bottle, drink out of it and throw it away. How does it make sense? It makes sense when you are able to get things done from yourself. So Bahubali movie mein, the main idea was to give the cinematic viewers a different experience. Jahan par normal movie dekhte the, we wanted to develop a movie which was into a technology called as VR, virtual reality. So we ensure jo unka scene jahan par hone wala, let's assume we are in ITS. We recorded the complete ITS campus using those cameras. Then the movie was also shot using those cameras. Usse kya hua? Each and every actor, if they come and act or let's say talk in front of the camera, it appears as if they are talking to us. So once you use your VR glasses or let's say goggles and see them, you will feel as if you are available in that particular set and you are interacting with that. Was it different? Does it make sense? Aaj ke cinema mein, did it stand up? Yes, it did. So, if you see ICT's role, let's say in a nation building activity, let me start with a small timeline. 1970, let's say, is when India, they have set up something called as Department of Electronics. Department of Electronics in India was set up in 1970. And 1977, an institution was set up which was called as NIC. Do you guys know the full form? National Informatics? Good. So it was set up in 1977. And 1988 or 87 is when the Ministry of IT was put across as a proposal. Will you believe it? 1988 and 1998 is when the ministry came into purpose. Today we are in 2016, we are talking about something called as Digital India. We have ensured every aspect of you guys are completely covered. If I have to talk about top, let's say 10 countries with, let's say, maximum ICT reach, can you guys name the top 3? Top 3 countries where the ICT reach is the maximum. No.
Japan.
No.
China.
No, no.
India.
France.
No. I'll name them for you. A country called as Finland comes as first in terms of penetration of ICT. Number 2, followed by Iceland. And third, a country you would have not even heard about, Slovenia. Why? They have ensured three main pillars of ICT are covered. Why do you think an ICT has to be, let's say, set up in a country? What are the purpose? It has to cater to the citizen. Let's say with all the basic services and all those things covered. Number two, it addresses the grievances without you going and waiting for it. And number three, it makes your life easier. All these three aspects were covered in these countries and they have ensured that citizens are trouble free. It was done in a survey and it is available for you in public domain. And US, for your information, comes as a distant second. It is nothing but from your birth to your death, all the certificates and all those things are digitally maintained. In a country of, let's say, 1.2 plus billion people, aaj ki date is not even existing. It may be existing partially, but it is not full-fledged. Think of the opportunity you guys have growing across. Number two, have you heard something related to education from India in ICT? Globally, India is the biggest example of education when it comes to the globe. There is a place in India, okay, wherein there's a state assume, which is known for the ICT implementation at its peak. Can you guess which state it is? The state is Kerala, wherein 1.6 million people are trained every year with an initiative called as ITH School. Presentation goes across, they mention a special place for Kerala in their presentation, saying it is implemented in such a massive scale and that stands out as an example. 1.6 million people covered. Or what they basically do is nothing but something under Digital India Initiative, which is called as e-Pathshala. All the schools, be it any, let's say, medium, you call it CBSE, ICSE, whatever you call it, matriculation, however it gets defined, have been classified. And they are planning to unify the education system. Does it make sense? Yes, it does. Yes, it does. So, this is how we see ICT, let's say, progressing in nation building. Ask if, let's say, on the GDP part, how much do you think a GDP gets contributed from ICT as a service? Can you guys guess? Any guess? Guess any percentage? 25, okay. Any other guess? No, we are close to 40% when it comes to the GDP contribution from ICT and related services. Agriculture contribution 17% there, but ICT has been an enabler when it comes to all the related services. Education ka we have discussed. For climate change, can you guys guess how it is being used as on day? Have you heard about a term called as analytics? Analytics ka tools wagera aata hai. They use it for something called as weather modeling, weather prediction. All these things are done using an ICT driven engine. So ICT is an enabler. Let's say if a tsunami is to hit the coast, it can predict this. And there is an initiative also, those people staying closer to the coastal areas have been enabled with something called as SMS alert or a cyclone warning. How is it done? It has been done through all the surveys and all the required details have been stored with the system and they will be alerted when it comes. So that's an ICT initiative we are talking about.
That's what happens when a person who works on ground, when he starts speaking, you will have so much examples, so much discussion on such topics. I would definitely request my Gandhanji to have a separate session of 2 hours, 3 hours for our students. And definitely we will transfer
for all of us to be here. You know, you can call us, we can come here for recruiting and all those things. Do you know why we as an organization or let's say an individual come over here? It's to come and learn, let's say from the new generation. There are a lot of things that you guys can come in, change the way the systems are existing. Any company, let's say, which has been existing for the last 200 years, assume, I'm not taking any names, if they have to keep the current pace of the employees, they have to learn from the new generation. So you guys have to carry it across. Wish you all the best, as always. So we will look forward for a different session from you guys. All the best.